if you have L and U, you can easily verify that A equals L times U. But given A, how do we factorize A? So how do we find L and U efficiently? That is what you will learn in this video. So, U is easy. U is just an echelon form of A, where you use only row additions. Okay, you can generalize this by using swaps, but for this example, we'll use only row additions. Well, when doing row reduction, you use mostly row additions anyway. Now remember, you can write this process of row reduction as U equals some multiplications as elementary matrices on the left. So, you start with your matrix A, you multiply with one elementary matrix on the left, that yields one row reduction step, so the full row reduction is done by using several multiplications on the left with elementary matrices E1 up till EP. And that gives you your echelon form of A. Okay, that's the easy part. How to find the echelon form U, but how can we find the L matrix in an efficient way? Now, we have U equals this product that you know times A. Now we can invert this product, bring it to the other side. Then we get EP up till E1 inverse times U equals A. But there you have your L. This over here is just your L, so your L is the inverse of EP up till E1. And if you multiply this out, if you take the product of the inverse of a product, that yields the product of the inverses, but then in the reverse order, so like this. So now you know how to compute your L. But this is really inefficient, and we want to find an efficient algorithm. So we have to do something a bit smarter. So what do? First, we put an identity matrix over here. And now you see how you can find L. So what you basically do, you start with your identity matrix, and you do the row operations which reduce A to U. You do the same operations, but now in the inverse order. So you start with P and you end with 1. And the inverse operation. So that's how you can find your L. So keep track of what row operations you do on A to get U. Then start with identity matrix, do the same operations, but then their inverses and in the inverse order. So that's summarized here. So you row reduce A to U using only row additions. Okay, you know how to do that. You did it a lot of times already. And now those same operations, well, the inverse of those operations in the inverse order, those reduce your identity matrix to L. So let's see a small example. So we start with our matrix A over here. Now we reduce A to its echelon form. Only one step is needed. You add minus 2 times the first row to the second one, and then you have your echelon matrix U. So how do you now find your L? You start with the identity matrix, and you do the inverse operations in inverse order. Okay, there's only one operation, so that's easy. So you do this one operation, but then it's inverse. So instead of subtracting twice the first row from the second, you have to add it twice. And there you have your matrix L. So you see, actually, it's not so difficult to find L and U. You only have to be able to reduce A to U. And then you start with your identity matrix, and with similar operations, you find your L.